Our next speaker is Haruka Ikeda, and I'll let him introduce the year.
Yes. Thank you for the introduction. I am Haruka Ikeda. Today, I'd like to talk to you about my proposal named Bilateral Motion Display, which is a strategy to provide multiple visual perception using after-image effects for specific motion. First, let me explain a little about myself. I am a master's student in the University of Tokyo in Japan. My research mainly focuses on high-speed image processing, and now I'm trying to combine such field and human performance of perceiving outer world. Today, I propose a system that enables multiple users to obtain completely different visual perception by looking at the same screen but with different eye movements. Let's begin with the background of our research. These days, there has been a growing demand for providing information with displays or projections. Especially, technologies to provide user-oriented view is attracting more and more attention. The figures below are an example of multi-view lenticular display system that was proposed in 2009. The left side figure is an image with observers when observers watch the display from the left side, and the right side figure is an image from the right side observers. You can see that the both images are different. The system enabled multiple users to simultaneously obtain their own images on the same screen, but according to their eye positions. But the systems required the special materials of lenticulars as screens to be displayed, so the practical installations are limited. Speaking of the range of applications of such systems, in addition to the needs in entertainment or communicative tools, in the fields of security technology, it's important that the information is secretly embedded and reveal its hidden information only to the specific users. The figures are one of such information hiding methods. As shown in the left side figure, we can only see the meanless waved patterns as it is, but actually information is embedded in them. When the patterns are shot by a digital camera in a specific angle, the hidden information are revealed. In the right side figure, you can see that an emblem pattern appears. However, the system does not provide the direct perception to the observers, but requires some complex decoding process to extract the hidden information using cameras. From all these previous approaches, it can be said that there are many advantages in conveying information that is tailored to some specific targeted group of users. But the methods so far required special equipment or materials like lenticular mirrors. Such requirements could be obstacle in installing them in the real context of applications. Also, those systems mainly targeted to static users who observe the display from a very limited angle. But in order to extend the range of applications in practical use, it's important to develop a display system that can target users with high-speed movements. In order to build a dynamic system depending on observers' movement, we focused on technologies to display information based on characteristics of human visual perception. Some display systems realized visual aerial images to users with simple equipment. The figure is an example of electric lighting clock. When the vertical LED arrays move laterally from left to side with flicking high speeds, two-dimensional images can be perceived as a result of after-image effects. In some studies, the duration time of after-image is said to be 100 milliseconds or longer. In 2007, a system called Saccade-based display realized two-dimensional images using this after-image principle conversely, that is, the light sources are fixed, and instead, the observer's gaze points are supposed to be shifted. The term circuit means high-speed eye movements. As the model shown in the right side figure, vertically fixed LED light sources are set, and patterns flash at high speed. And when observers watch the light sources with their eyes moving from left to right, watching the flashing patterns, the flashing patterns were temporarily integrated in the horizontal direction in their views, and they are perceived as two-dimensional images. However, in that system, when an observer repeatedly moves his or her eyes, gaze laterally, and the light sources are scanned or integrated in the view in the opposite direction, the synthesized afterimage may appear as mirrored ones. This is because the perceived images in that system only appear as a set of spatially arranged single pixel with stripped shaped image components. They are displayed successively in time series, and so when the eye movements are in the opposite direction, they are arranged in a reversed order. Such mistakenly reversed perception is not desirable because the target images could be interpreted differently when turned over. Also, depending on the speed of eye gaze, there is a possibility that after images are too widely distorted in the lateral direction and that extended after images are perceived. Therefore, I propose an image processing technique to display images that can be perceived differently when observed with different eye movements, while preventing the appearance of mirrored or distorted images. That is, users who observe the display with specific motion can perceive the appearance of the appropriate target images, while the other users without moving their eyes cannot gain the embedded information. Our approach is new in that the perceived images change depending on not the observer's position, but on their eye movements. So, multiple users can gain different contents at the same time while they're watching the same screen and the same direction, but if they are moving differently. In the following, I'll explain the image processing techniques and the principle of the proposed methods. The first process is the generation of the displaying images. In our system, binary images are input first as the target image to be perceived. For example, suppose the fish silhouette in the figure is set as a target. Then, from the input image, slices of image components are extracted along the 45-degree diagonal lines. Please look at the figures. The process of extraction can be regarded as a process of taking intersection of the target image and the diagonally arranged multiple lines. As a result, slice images, as indicated by the orange square in the figure, are gained. The generated images will be displayed or projected. Then, the points at which the slices are picked up are shifted and displayed in time series. In the figures, each of the three columns respectively show the images of three successively frames in the projection. Then, let's look at the reconstruction process of the target image based on the generated images. When observers watch the successively cut out slices with lateral eye movements, the target image is reconstructed as a result of integrated after image when the eye gaze is the same direction and speed as the shift of the cut out process. This occurs because the movement of the viewing area is corresponding to the flow of the target image components. In the figures, you can see that each frame is shifted laterally. This means that the shift of the eye movements of observers. On the other hand, observers with different direction or velocity, or observers who are not moving at all, cannot correctly reconstruct the target image. This is because the diagonal line slice lines includes both the vertical and horizontal components, and that only the horizontal ones are extracted during the horizontal eye movements of the observers, while the vertical directions are kept. In other words, in order to reconstruct and perceive the target image correctly, the slice components must be appropriately arranged in the viewing lighting of observers, viewing sight of observers. Therefore, the system ends up to provide meaningless information to users with incorrect biases, but selectively provides the images to users with specific direction and movements. Taken together, by using the set of 45-degree horizontal lines, we could realize the selective perception to specific targeted users. So, when we put another target image into the minus 45-degree diagonal lines, that is, when we repeat the same process of extracting slice components in the down diagonal lines as well as the upside lines, then users of different velocities will perceive different perception respectively, but at the same time. For example, when two target images are the letters of A and B, and the lines rising up and down diagonally correspond respectively, the displayed images will be generated as shown in the right side figure. But such images is still not enough to achieve our goals. That is, the slices that are extracted from the original images are too dense that the hidden information is easily recognized, even without the intended eye movements of the observers. Our purpose was to provide selective information to users who have specific velocities. So, the synthesized images should appear only when the observer moves his or her gaze and the meaningless patterns are shown otherwise. Hence, reducing the number of projected slices are more preferable. Like this, after reducing the number of slices, this figure might be more acceptable. But it is not enough to say that they are completely embedded as hidden images. So, to prevent unintentional perception of the embedded images, we think of additionally putting some dummy horizontal slices. This figure is an example of image with added horizontal noise. They are only perceived as horizontally stripped lines in the synthesized after image when observers move their eyes horizontally. Because they have no more than one pixel width in the vertical direction of the noise. Hence, the existence of lines do not greatly interfere the perception of the provided image as after image. Let's take a look at the demonstration of our system. You can see that when the camera moves from left to right, the letter A appears, and the letter B appears when right. Our system only requires a high frame rate projector and a screen, or a high-speed display system to show as many image components as possible. This is another example. The picture of a go sign and a silhouette of kangaroo are embedded in them. This is the result of the short images. And finally, this is an image gained when the horizontal noises are added. We confirm that the figures still look clear even with noises. Again, take a close look at the two pairs of input images and the corresponding perceivable results. The results respectively reflect the input pair images. The top row is a go sign and a kangaroo picture, and the bottom row is the letters A and B. They are synthesized with enough accuracy to be recognized or readable. So it can be said that our process made it possible to provide dominantly one image out of the two input images to observers with specific eye movements, without requiring for synthesizing our gaze timing or complex process like displaying to extract the hidden information. Because the embedded images can be perceived from any viewing point as long as the projected images are observable, so multiple users can experience the respective perception simultaneously. This is the result when the additional noise exists. We can still clearly recognize the kangaroo picture. This means that even after some horizontal slices are added to the projection, the perception is not majorly affected because the whole after images are two-dimensional while the noise is just like lines. So it can be said that the horizontal noise contributes to the embedding of the image only to the observers with incorrect velocities and does not refrain the target users from perceiving the correct image. In our system, the speed range of users who can perceive the target image is limited to some specific range, so there is no fear of unintentionally providing mirrored or distorted image. On the other hand, by expanding the aspect ratio of the original image in advance, we can intentionally set aspect ratio to be perceived. The figures A and B show that the users moved the eyes in the same speed, but the perceivable images were different in each video. Our system has a degree of freedom in providing such images. Our system has the potential of expanding range of displaying device and is applicable in various situations. For example, in a road sign, traffic information or speeding notices can be realized. By selectively providing only to the drivers that move with certain direction and speed. For example, a slow sign to cars that are moving at greater than the speed limit, or a go sign to cars that need to speed up to avoid causing traffic jams after an upslope, and so on. Also, our system application in security technologies are also considerable as a method of embedding information while targeted to limited users. Especially, the additional noise to hide images are useful to tell computers and humans because such noise will let computers misunderstand the embedded image, while we humans can still recognize the patterns of information even with incomplete figures. This is similar in concept to the CAPTCHA in security technology, which is the techniques often used in confirmations in websites as shown in the right side figure. A limitation in our implementation is that the clearness of perceivable after image depends on the target image themselves. That is, figures mainly composed of thin lines are easier to be recognized, while the images with high density of brightness areas, such as a field silhouette, is hard to be perceived because the input two patterns are likely to be overlapped in each frame of the projection. I want to tackle this problem in the future, for example, by optimizing the arrangements of image components based on the brightness distribution of the target images. Then, clearer image perception will be expected. In addition, I want to extend the system in the future to embed more than two images at the same time. I think there is a possibility in realizing such extension by using more efficient use of the projected areas. For example, so far our system only uses pixels in 45 degree lines, so the remaining part of displaying images could be used to process to embed more information. And I propose a new system wherein a series of patterns displayed at high speed could result in multiple users as a result of after image effects during specific gaze motions. That's it for my slides. Thank you for listening. I'll be happy if you have questions.
Very nice magic trick here.
Thank you.
Any questions from the audience?
You talked very interesting. You talked about you having multiple images. Have you looked into the use of color in terms of developing different images, and what impact does color have?
Thank you. In our system, binary images need to be input in the system because the perceivable images are a result of integrated arranged image components. In our system, we use the high-speed projector, but the projector itself only projects the black and white images. But if a high-speed projector with colored ones, colored perception will be achieved. But in that case, the colors are only black and other colors, because the binary input is only acceptable. So the full color images is difficult at that time in our system.
Any other questions?
How about the variety of the moving directions?
Yes. About the direction, the direction depends on the parameters in image processing systems, like the distance between the slices or the range of velocities to perceive. For example, a high speed projection with high density image components will lead to higher speed perception, higher speed observers to perceive.
Can a display like out of home signage be used instead of the high speed projector?
You mean the signage like a display?
Yes.
Yes, it is possible, but our system requires a high speed display. So the frame rate is high, it is possible.
Hi, really great work. So you mentioned one of the benefits is potentially like hiding certain information from different users, or presenting different users with different information. I was wondering if you've done any user testing to see how well the information for the other user is effectively hidden. Like for example, in the kangaroo and go thing, could a person who was looking for the kangaroo see, you know, how much of that other image were they actually able to perceive, if at all?
And subjective experiments are not conducted so far, and I just only checked myself. But so I think it's difficult to evaluate the things of how clearness of images. So I'm considering of how to evaluate such systems. But thank you.
Anything else? Just maybe, how large could the display be? The display dimmer.
Large.
How large can they be? Because I would figure it would change. It would change the view angle toward a very large image.
Yeah, it depends on the eye gaze speed, because it is based on the after image effects. And after image effects is said to be duration. The duration time is about 100 milliseconds, so the extended range is the pixels where the observers can perceive in the time scale of 100 milliseconds. So it depends on the observers, but if the eye movements are high, the extension range is wider.
Nice.
So obviously the perceptual phenomenon is depends on the persistence of the retinal image or after image in your terminology. So how long is the time window that we are talking about? Is that 100 millisecond or half a second? How long is the integration time, the persistence, the duration?
Duration of integration is 100 milliseconds.
Well, you can meet with him anytime during the coffee break, so I think that's about, it's about that time, isn't it? We'll thank our speaker. Yeah. And if I'm correct.